Pharmacology may DC for nurses. In this video, we are going to discuss about antiseptics, disinfectants, and insecticides. So what is disinfection? It is the process of destruction or removal of microorganisms and reducing them to the level not harmful to health. What is disinfectant? These are chemical agents which are used for antiseptic or disinfectant purpose. What are all the characteristics of an ideal disinfectant? There are basic characteristics which are necessary to make the chemical as a disinfectant. The first one is broad spectrum antimicrobial activity. So it should cover most of the microorganisms when we clean the surface with the disinfectant. It should kill most of the microbes. The next one, non-toxic. As we are using it in skin and surface or the equipments, it should be a non-toxic. The next one is fast acting. So it should act fast when we wash our hands or when we use it in the surface. So if it takes time, then the effectiveness of the disinfectant is reduced. So this is also an important characteristic. It should be a fast acting in killing the microbes. The next one is odorless. It should not give any bad odor. It should be either odorless or it should give a pleasant odor. So surface compatibility. This is nothing but when we use it on any surfaces, it should not cause any damage to the surface. If we use it in tile, marble or wooden floors, so it should not cause any damage. That is surface compatibility. Another characteristic is economical. So it should be cheaper and available one which we can buy it easily. Next one is easy to use. Of course, easy use, usable is a very important aspect of disinfectant. The next one is soluble. So this disinfectant, what we are buying, so it should be diluted and prepared. So mostly it should be a soluble one, not affected by physical factors like any environmental change or temperature change. It should not affect the property of the disinfectant. The next one is stable on storage. When we keep it on the storage, when we store it, it should possess the same characteristics. It should not change its properties on storage. So these are all the basic characteristics which are essential for ideal disinfectant. The first one is broad spectrum, non-toxic effect, fast acting, odorless, surface compatibility, economical, easy to use, soluble, not affected by physical factors, and stable on storage. The next is effectiveness of disinfectants. The effectiveness of disinfectant depends on some factors. What are all they? The first one is type of contamination. What type of contamination is the very important thing which makes the disinfectant effective? Degree of contamination. How much is the contaminated area? So it depends upon that the disinfectant chemical should be used. Amount of proteinaceous material. For example, when there is a spill of urine and there is a spill of blood, so the proteinaceous content is more in the blood. So the effectiveness of the same disinfectant when you use in the urine spill and blood spill will be different. So you should use a concentrated one in case of proteinaceous material. Chemical nature of the disinfectant. So the chemical nature of the disinfectant also makes the or decides the effectiveness of the disinfectant. Contact time. How long the disinfectant is kept for cleaning the contaminated area also decides the effectiveness of disinfectant. Concentration of the disinfectant plays a very important role in the effectiveness of cleaning. So these are all the factors which are essential to make the disinfectant effective, like type of contamination, degree of contamination, amount of proteinaceous material, chemical nature, contact time and concentration. So you should know which disinfectant should be effective in case of contamination. The next is types of disinfectants. There are plenty of types which are available in the market and it is upgraded frequently. And we have mnemonics here like PharmaGod, which helps us to remember all the types of disinfectants. The P represents phenol derivative, which includes Crisol, Lysol, Dettol and Chlorhexidine. You all know that what is Dettol? It's a chloroxynol which is used as a phenol derivative, which is very commonly used in household and hospital industries. So Chlorhexidine is a healthcare industrial phenol derivative, which is used as a scrubbing agent. And this Savlon is a mixture of Chlorhexidine and Cetrimide. So the phenol derivatives includes Savlon, Dettol, Crisol, Lysol and Chlorhexidine. The next H represents halogens. Halogens include mainly two things. One is iodine and chlorine solutions. The iodine includes like betadine, tincture iodine, all those things are iodine compound. There are iodine ointment which is used as a fungicide in ringworm infestation also. The chlorine solution is a very popular community disinfectant where we usually use it to clean the wells and water supplies. So the chlorine types of chlorine derivatives are chlorinated lime, that is bleaching powder, chloramine and usol solution. So these all are halogen products which are used in community and hospital based disinfectants. The next A represents alcohol, which includes ethyl alcohol and isopropyl alcohol. These two are concentrated use of these two will give a very effective antiseptic activity, and most of the sanitizers includes this alcohol as a ingredient. But what is the disadvantage of this alcohol derivative? It has a flammable property and it is very poor in killing spores. The next is XA is aldehyde, which includes formaldehyde and glutaraldehyde. Formaldehyde is a very popular antiseptic reagents used in the hospital industries. 1% in 200 dilution, which is effective for killing all the microbes in surgical instruments and gloves and embalming and preserving the tissues. So formalin solutions are mostly used to store anatomical products, and as well as it is used for fumigation and sterilizing instruments. The next is surface reactants or surfactants. The common one is soaps. All the soaps are prepared with the help of potassium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide and vegetable oil. So some of the soaps includes sodium lauryl sulfate as a ingredient. So all these soaps are effective as a antiseptics. The M represents metals. Metals like mercury, silver and copper are very effective antiseptics. Some of the silver compounds like silver sulfur diazine is very effective against pseudomonas in case of burn wounds. And the next A represents acids. Acids like boric acid, which is effective, important component along with usol. So like along with the chlorine and boric acid, it makes a very effective antiseptics like usol solutions. The G represents gases. So ethylene dioxide, beta propionic propiolactone, all these two are very popular gases which are used in fumigations or destruction of or disinfectants of instruments, especially like which cannot be washed by the solutions, like endoscopic equipments, bronchoscopic equipments, all those things which we cannot wash with water. So these gases are effective in case of disinfecting these kind of instruments. So the next O represents oxidizing agents, that is hydrogen peroxide and potassium permanganate. These two are very effective high level disinfectants which kills most of the microbes and effectively used in hospital industries. The next D of Pharmagod represents dyes. There are two types of dyes which are very popular as an antiseptics: aniline and acridine dyes. So examples of aniline dye is gentian violet and acridine dye is acriflavin. So when we use all these disinfectants, that depends upon whether you use it like an antiseptic or a disinfectant solutions. The concentration changes when you use as an antiseptics and when you use as a disinfectants. So the chemicals we use are common, but when the concentration differs when you use it as an antiseptics or a disinfectants. What is the mechanism of action of most of the disinfectants? So they disrupt cellular structure by different mechanism of action. The first one is oxidation of bacterial protoplasm. The chemicals like potassium permanganate, hydrogen peroxide and halogens, what they do is they oxidate the bacterial protoplasm and kill or destroy the microbes. Coagulation of protein in bacterial wall. So the protein material which are present in the bacterial wall is get coagulated and destructed in case when we use chemicals like phenols, chlorhexidines, alcohols and aldehydes. So all these disinfectants coagulate the protein material in the bacterial wall. Increases the permeability of the bacterial cell membrane. The common one is soap. What is the action of soap is it increases the permeability of the bacterial cell membrane by destroying the bacteria. So these are the basic mechanism of action for most of the disinfectants. We can classify the disinfectants as low level disinfectants, intermediate level disinfectant and high level disinfectants. It depends upon the action of the disinfectants. So low level disinfectants kills most of the vegetative bacteria except Mycobacterium tuberculosis and some fungi and some viruses. So these germicides are used as hospital disinfectants or sanitizers. The examples are phenols, ammonium compounds and soaps. So all are soaps, ammonium compounds and phenols are considered as low level disinfectants. The next one is intermediate level disinfectants. In this, what happens? These disinfectants, they kill vegetative microorganisms including tuberculosis, fungi, and it inactivates most viruses, but it will not kill spores. These are approved hospital disinfectants. They are also tuberculosidal. They are commonly used on all laboratories and hospitals as a disinfectants. Example, alcohols, hypochlorite solution and iodine. The next is high level disinfectants. This procedure kills vegetative microorganisms, inactivates all the viruses, but not necessarily high numbers of bacterial spores. Some of the bacterial spores also destructed by the high level disinfectants, but complete sporicidal happens only during sterilization, not during disinfectants. Such disinfectants are capable of sterilization when the contact time is relatively long. But high level disinfectants, when you use it for a longer period, it can act like a sterilizer, sterilizing solutions. These chemicals are classified by FDA as sterilant or disinfectants. Example, hydrogen peroxide and aldehydes. That's why we use formaldehyde in case of fumigation to kill most of the microorganism which is considered as high level disinfectants. So according to the action of the disinfectants, we classify it as low level, intermediate level and high level disinfectants. Next we will move on to insecticides. Is it necessary that we should study insecticide in the pharmacology? We will see. So what is insecticide? Chemicals which are used to kill the insects, we call it as insecticides. So if you see the classification, the insecticides are broadly classified as natural and synthetic. The natural insecticides are again classified as plant-based and mineral oils, and synthetic again classified as inorganic insecticides and organic insecticides. And this organic insecticides is again classified as into four categories, like organochlorines, organophosphates, carbamates, and synthetic phytotheroids. So all these classifications comes under organic, synthetic organic insecticides. Inorganic synthetic insecticides includes, the example is Paris green. So what is the use of insecticides in hospitals or in medicine? If we see the prevention of zoonotic diseases like leishmaniasis, we use insecticides to kill all the rats or other zoonotic animals which is causing diseases. Malaria control. Malaria is controlled effectively with the help of insecticides. So what they do is they kill malaria mosquitoes and mosquito larvae by using the insecticides. Reduce vector-borne diseases like ticks, mites, mosquitoes, house flies, all these things can be controlled by using effectively the insecticides. Treating external parasites, superficial skin parasitic infections can be treated with the help of the insecticides, but you should make sure that it should not cross the systemic circulation. Control insects and rodents in the hospital. So in some hospitals, if we want to control the insects and rodents, and we use this insecticides. So these are all the areas where in healthcare we use insecticides as a preventive method. So in the use of antiseptics or disinfectants or insecticides, the nurses play an important role. The nurse should be aware of what all the types of antiseptics or disinfectants they use and how to use it. The nurse must know the time course of action of the specific agent. So she should know how much contact time will kill the microbes. So she, when using or sterilizing the equipments or necessary things, of course the nurse should have a knowledge on the disinfectant and its properties. Washing and using proper antiseptics as per the need. She should know the protocol for handling antiseptics. Nurse should establish a routine schedule for preparing new solutions and cleaning reusable containers. So whenever she take anything, she should label it properly, like when it is diluted, how much is the dilution. Label reusable containers with date each time they are washed and dried and refilled. All containers should have lids which should be well tightened and safely stored. Nurse should keep in mind that concentrated antiseptic solution should be stored in a cool, dark area. It should not be left to direct sunlight or excessive heat. Smoking, eating and drinking in chemical storage areas should be strictly prohibited. Generally, especially these chemicals has a flammable property when it is mixed with alcohol. So it is safer to avoid smoking and eating and drinking. Wear PPE whenever needed when she uses disinfectants or antiseptics. Thank you. See you in next video.